What up, guys? It's your brother Joe here, and welcome once again to F1 2020 My Team Career Mode. We're here at Austria, and you are watching me getting it very wrong in practice while on one of my simulation programs. I think it was race pace, but now we head into Q1, and I'm giving it everything, as I always do in this session, to try and get into the second part of qualifying. And to be honest, I actually feel like we can be quite competitive here, because my pace in practice was promising, and I don't know, I just felt like this could be a race where we could quite comfortably get some good points. So within Q1, we've managed to get into the top 10, which only fuels my feeling, but unfortunately in Q2, we weren't able to go quite as fast as Q1, and we start the race from P13.
Welcome to the beautiful Styrian Mountains for another chapter in the story of the Austrian Grand Prix. It's one of the shortest laps on the calendar today then, with 7 rights and just 3 lefts, making up the 10 corners of this high-speed circuit. Turn 2 is barely a corner at all. They'll be flat out through there, a left-hand kink into the uphill braking zone of Turn 3. Turns 1, 3 and 4 are all potential opportunities to overtake. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of Turn 1. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
There are 3 main things to worry about there, Crofty. Positioning, awareness and discipline. First, you have to put your car in a bit of space and make sure you have room to react to what the others are doing. Then you have to watch your mirrors and listen to the sounds around you to get a sense of where everyone is. And finally, just don't get too greedy. Just because a gap exists doesn't always mean you should go for it.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Good job yesterday from Valtteri Bottas. The Finn starts from pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Vettel, Leclerc, Max Verstappen, and Albon, Perez, Sainz, Ricciardo, and Lance Stroll, Giovinazzi, Norris, Oldtimer, and Raikkonen, Kvyat, Ocon, Kevin Magnussen, and Mick Schumacher, Russell, Grosjean, Latifi, and Pierre Gasly picks up the final grid slot today. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today?
So, P13 on the grid for this Austrian Grand Prix. Where can we finish? I feel like we could get some points. It's lights out and away we go. And we've made an absolutely incredible start already into the top 10. And that's before we even reach the first corner. But I've missed my braking spot. I'm having to go out wide. And I'm pretty sure there's an illegal overtake or two in there. Yep, I've got to give the place back to Sainz. But we missed our braking spot. But we've still gained a few places off the start. Look at Ricciardo just sending it up my inside. I've missed my brakes. Ricciardo's still there, and we're sandwiched between what I think was Ricciardo and Albon. And Albon just getting bulged by the pair of us. And Ricciardo's still on my right. He is not giving this up at all. Ricciardo wanting that P6. And unfortunately, we had no other choice but to just submit there and accept that Ricciardo had got the job done, and I was having a cheeky look there, but that's resulted in me missing my braking spot, and now we've got Sainz sending it up the inside of the left-hander. I'm trying to hang it out around the outside. I've gone deep, though, and that's allowed Sainz through, and Albon is now right on my chuff, getting ready to pounce at his chosen moment. Still having a look to get back past Sainz, but we're currently in P8, so we are just about inside the points, which is all well and good, but I definitely think P6 could have been on the cards there. So we're going to keep hounding Sainz. Going to try and get that place back. We're going to dive up the inside of the hairpin. We've made contact there. That's not worked for us at all. And in fact, now, if anything, we've got to watch out for Albon, because he's having a look up the inside. He sent it up the inside. Albon catching me napping there. And that is P8 for Alex Albon. And now we've got to try and get him back. We're coming up to Turn 2, I believe it is. And we're just going to send it straight up the inside. Albon wasn't prepared for that one at all. And we catch Albon napping in the same way he caught us napping. But next lap, same corner. Albon having a look up the inside. The momentum he's got going into that corner is something else. We're just not able to match the momentum of that Red Bull. Lando Norris now right behind me. And this is turning into a very tasty scrap here for P7, I believe. P6, actually, sorry. As we send it back up the inside of Albon. And I want to get after Sainz and Ricciardo. I don't really want to be fighting Albon that much longer. And in fact, I think Albon has dropped back from us now. So we can now start getting after Carlos Sainz. Albon once again back on my rear as soon as possible. I tell you what, Albon is the fly in my soup. The one that keeps coming in my face. Because he just does not. He just will not leave me alone. Sainz has now got past Ricciardo while we've been battling Albon. And we're now going to have a look up the inside of Ricciardo here. We're pulling a Ricciardo overtake on Ricciardo. Going out a bit wide though, but we've made the move stick. And I think Albon has followed him through now. We just cannot get shot of Albon, no matter how hard I'm pushing. Coming into the left-hander, we've gone deep, we're losing it there. We've gone straight into Albon, who's lost a bit of his front wing. And we've been collected and spun by Ricciardo. Another race, another incident where we've collected someone. France, it was Bottas. Here, it was Albon. And then Ricciardo getting collected by my recovery. And we both spin. A bit of a silly move for me, which results in a new front wing needed. I mean, I needed a new front wing anyway because I took damage early on in the race. And we are now back out and hoping for us to salvage whatever we could. I think I took quite a big bit of damage when I hit Albon recovering. So it wasn't just his wing, it was mine. There was a virtual safety car that came out as well because of my spin with Ricciardo. And like I said, I just took that opportunity to make my first pit stop and hope that, you know, we could have a decent stint where we could recover something. We're into lap 13 now, and I was considering at this point retiring from the race, but I just thought, now let's push on and let's just try and make this stint last as long as we can, take on softs again at the end. And in fact, when everyone had pitted, we'd made our way to 8th and we were just pushing on. Even though the tyres were feeling pretty dead, we're just pushing and pushing and hoping that with the soft tyres on towards the end of the race, we might be able to make a charge. And in fact, making this stint last as long as we did is what inevitably helped us out as we make our second stop now for the soft tyres. And in fact, it's not as bad as it could have been. I think we're going to come out in P15 just behind Kevin Magnussen. And, you know, for a race that went as wrong as it did, we definitely saved what we could from it. There was a bit of damage limitation, as we're going to waste no time getting past Magnussen. He's gone very defensive, but I've just taken him straight around the outside. The advantage of my fresh soft tyres over his slightly older hard tyres just showing there. Next up, we have Esteban Ocon, and we're going to go for it there, but Ocon's just not giving me the room. I'm just checking to make sure that we don't have damage, and we didn't. But for a race that went as wrong as it did, you know, getting caught up in Ricciardo and having that spin and then making a pit stop, we definitely made the most of that virtual safety car. And I think that's helped me salvage what I can at the moment of this race. But we're now having a look at the rear of Esteban Ocon for 13th place. I didn't waste any time getting that move done, did I? Absolutely no time. And now we're on the back of the torpedo. Am I going to be able once again to torpedo the torpedo? Not there, I'm not. That's a bit of a strange look I was having there. I don't think my heart was really in that one. But now we're back behind him. We're catching up. We're in the slipstream. We're in the DRS. And I think this is going to be a move that is done before we even get to the corner. Yep, that move is done. Next up is Lance Stroll for P11. We are making our way through the field here. And maybe, just maybe, points are still on the cards in this race. As Valtteri Bottas now drops out of the race with a mechanical failure and nearly getting caught by Mick Schumacher there, who for some reason just didn't seem to notice Bottas until the last minute. What was my teammate doing? Not the race you want to be doing that when I've got a contract decision to make. But anyway, now we're on the tail of Stroll. This is going to become for 10th place and a world championship point. Because quite naturally, Bottas was ahead of us. And now, here we go. We're going to have a look up the inside here, maybe. It's going to be a dive bomb. And yes, that is a move done. P10 into the points. And we're now setting after the two alphas that are together of Giovinazzi and Raikkonen. And they are battling for 8th. Albon is right behind them at the moment. But let's be honest, Albon is going to make easy work of the two alphas. Because the Red Bull is just so much faster. And we now come onto the penultimate lap. There's Giovinazzi in 9th. Raikkonen has got ahead of him. So we've got some work to do here if we are going to pass both these Alfa Romeos and get even more points from this race. So a potential P8 up for grabs here. I'm giving it everything. Once again, ERS, DRS, rich mix. Making sure we've got the most speed we can have on the straight. We're going to dive up the inside of Giovinazzi. We completely sent it up the inside. And that is the move done on him. We're going to see a replay now. Giovinazzi, I don't think really expecting that one. Caught napping there. And once we were there, he didn't fight that one at all, really. And now we come into the last lap. There is Kimi Raikkonen just ahead of us. Can we take him? Can we get P8 from a race that went wrong, but we've salvaged it and we've managed to do some great damage limitation in it and forged an excellent comeback? But Raikkonen not being as easy to pass and easy to send it up as Giovinazzi was. Max Verstappen, meanwhile, has taken the win in the Austrian Grand Prix. But we're going to have a dive on Raikkonen here. And we have had a dive on Raikkonen. Maybe a little bit of contact, but we are up into P8. But Raikkonen coming back at me down the inside of that corner there. Clearly, my line there needs work because drivers are just able to send it up the inside. Raikkonen still alongside there, and Raikkonen getting back past me up into that P8. Can we try and take him back in the last few corners? I'm basically pushing him around the last corner. We're not able to make it past, but we still take P9 from the Austrian Grand Prix. What a race.
Smiling faces on the pit wall after a superb win here at Spielberg, and rightly so, a brilliant effort from the whole team. Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such an incredible result today?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs, and that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximise the strategy, and to stay out of trouble.
The drivers are en route to the podium as we speak. What a fantastic win for the Red Bull team. They performed exceptionally today, keeping us firmly on the edge of our seats throughout the entirety of the race. Congratulations to everyone at the team.
Well, what a recovery. After getting caught up by Ricciardo and going round, especially after I nearly wiped myself out of the race on Albon as well, I'm considering myself very lucky that we've even got points from this one. I do have to apologise for the incident with Albon there. If he hadn't been there to collect me, I would have completely gone round. So, and then also apologies for the incident with Ricciardo. You can see there, Mick Schumacher actually not finishing that much further off from me. So we've got a decision to make here. The championship is closing up between Hamilton and Verstappen. We're still in the top 10 in the standings and 7th in the constructors. Yeah, that was an exciting race. Here is the highlights reel. credit to Share Factory for all the amazing music that is on there that I can montage with. But yeah, like I said, Albon saving my race in the end until I went into Ricciardo. I'm a little bit disappointed with that incident, but these things happen. You know, we learn from them, and hopefully I will stop having these clumsy incidents with the AI. But right now, we've got an interview with Claire. I think I'll big up my aero department. Let's boost some morale. I did look in control of the car until I had an incident with Ricciardo, which a bit of my fault, really, because I did recover into him. I elect, I think, here to just to go with the no comment option. Because I don't have any comment. I was completely to blame for A, the collision with Albon, and B, the collision with Ricciardo. I've also seen comments about the French Grand Prix, which suggests me and Bottas was a racing incident. And I'd just like to say, having reviewed that, I'll go with that being a racing incident. Right, we have the impossible decision here. Do we fire Mick, or do we give him till the end of the season? Well, having thought about this extensively, despite the things he's put me through, like the incident in Canada for one, like what the hell was that, and his performances, I'm going to give him till the end of the season. I'm not Christian Horner. I don't fire my drivers mid-season. He's going to get to the end of the season, and if he can improve from the back, and he can, I don't know, get a good couple of points, then he can stay on until further notice. But right now, he stays on till the end of this season. Whether he stays on in season two, I don't know. Well, thank you so much for watching this episode of Career Mode. Until the next one, I've been Joe. Thank you and goodbye.